Hi, this is Mika, BMW San Francisco. Today I was allowed finally to video the new BMW i8, and not only video it, we're gonna drive it a little bit. So this is the new car. You can see a lot of videos, a lot of photos. I'm just gonna do a quick look. So from the back, first of all, the trunk. There's really no trunk. So all you have, the closer you can see, there's really small compartment. The charger will be there. And there's the back seat. I'm not gonna try to attempt to get into the back seat. It's possible. It's very, very tight. So just move a little bit. So assume small kids, maybe dogs, but really not for adults. The next thing is how to get in and out of this car. So there's actually, in the training videos from BMW, there was one video about how to get in and out of this car. So let's go and take a look. These are pivot doors. They're not really scissor, they're not power doors. You just push it on the side and push a little bit to pull it out. A lot of people are so concerned about how much room you need to open the door. It's actually not that much because it's going up. It's not going to the side. So just like a normal parking space will be just fine. All right, so the difference from other sports coupes is this. The carbon fiber frame is pretty high. So it's different getting in. It's a little bit different. So the easy way to do it is you just sit here, slide into the seat, put both your hands, both your feet in, and you're good. And then to close, grab the handle. Okay, so the cameraman was able to get in. Let's put our seat belts on and we're gonna take it out. All right, so you probably can find a lot of information about this car. It's not a really full electric, it's a hybrid. There's an engine in the front, there's an electric motor in the front that powers the front wheels. And there's a three-cylinder engine in the back that powers the rear wheels. The e-drive, there are a few modes in this car. The e-drive will just put it in electric mode only, and then you get in the mileage and you drive electric only. In regular mode, you have comfort mode and Eco Pro. Right now we're in comfort mode, and when the power is needed, it just powers up both engines at the same time, electric motor and the gas engine, and you get all the power. It's not just the power. The biggest difference with this car is that because of its shape, you sit so low, center of gravity is very low. The car is very light. It's all carbon fiber, and it's all-wheel drive. So that's it. I'm not gonna drive it too hard. This is our owner's demonstrator vehicle, so I have to be gentle with it. But they did let me drive it, and I want to get a feel for it. All right. So this regular mode going about 60. The thing that the handling is the most amazing thing. This is not a muscle car, it doesn't have 600 horsepower, anything like that. But the handling, that's what you feel and how this car feels. It sounds different too. That engine sounds pretty weird in the back. So something to get used to. It's very smooth. I mean, it's accelerates smoothly. It's not just jumping at you, but it's very smooth and very easy to drive. So this is comfort mode. I'm gonna try Eco Pro. So Eco Pro kind of takes the power away, just like in our other BMW with the driver dynamic controls. And really not big difference. So I'm gonna put it back to comfort. And we're gonna take this exit. This exit, there's a really tight turn, so I'm gonna take that turn and just test the headlight of this car. Then we'll whip around and go back on the highway again. Try some other stuff. Right. I hope nobody's going to be in front of it. So there's a regenerative braking. You can feel it slows you down. So this is it. This is all-wheel drive and solo. It just grabs their own. It doesn't matter the speed. You can take it at any speed. brakes, just whip around and do a U-turn. So that's the sound of the engine. You can hear it, you can hear the shift in. Sounds pretty cool. Alright, I'm gonna drive quickly. I'll put her to E-drive. So E-drive basically turns the engine off. Now it feels pretty much, the feel is like driving the BMW i3, just fully electric car. Obviously it's much stiffer, the handle is different, but in terms of power, that's what I would compare it to. Take a look at these displays, the driver displays. It's all digital, looks great. I'm sure it changes, there are different settings for it. I didn't play with it, but I'm sure I can adjust them. And I have pretty much same displays on the head-up display. There's the speed limit, the actual speed, everything is right in front of me. All the information about the car shows me the range, shows me the gas, everything. All right, so let's turn this off. And for acceleration, I'm gonna put it to sport. Okay, so this is different now. So that's the sport display. It's pretty much 60. So this is not quite, you know, I didn't push it, but this is, you can really feel how this car can get 0 to 60 in about 4 seconds. It sounds different now, it feels different. So now you really feel what this car is about. Let's whip it to another lane. It's super tight. Basically, you have four modes. There's E-Drive, Comfort, Eco Pro, and Sport mode. There are paddles. I did not try the manual shifting. I'm sure it's fun. I guess I can put it to E-drive mode. Power and speed reduced. And let's see what else. What else? What kind of fun stuff I can pull up here? Okay, E-drive display. Okay, so that's the mileage. So this car has 277 miles total, and the average mileage, I don't think it's ever been reset, as 27. So for a performance car, I think that's pretty good. Let's see what else we have. So there's no sport displays because this is pretty much what you have here. Not much on settings, same as any other car. Charging, okay, so this shows you what's going on with the charging. Okay, so this one has the driving assistant, basically frontal collision and pedestrian warning. So this is how you turn it on and off. This is pretty standard on new BMWs. X5, X3, all new models come up with the same feature. Honestly, the engine is off, very quiet. Again, very similar to the i3. And I'm gonna try to get a little bit more city driving once I get out of the traffic. So you saw the trunk. Under the hood, you're actually not even supposed to open it. When we had to open it, it's all electric out there. You're not supposed to, as a user, open it. It's a two-man job. You have to unhook something on both sides of the car, and then two people literally have to like take the hood off the car. Again, there's nothing you really need to do there. It's all electric, it's all high voltage, so for safety, it's all closed. There has to be some access to the engine in the back. Did not see the access, and that's it. Very tight seating position, very, very tight, like a cockpit type car. Everything's under the hand. There's one cup holder, a little bit of storage here, a little bit of storage there. Very tiny, love compartment. Okay, it's kind of the economy mode. Try it in sport again. So once you put it in sport, the engine kicks in. Take another shot of the display with the sport mode. Liking the sound of this engine. Okay, so the only thing it doesn't tell me which gear I'm in, which is kind of weird than I expected. Oh, yeah, no, now it does. Manual 2, manual 3, there we go. Let's see it again. Okay, I'm sorry. Yes, it does tell you the gear. It says S for sport and then the gear right in the corner. Alright, let's let the Prius go. Suspension is pretty tight. This is a rough road. You definitely can feel it right here. Not as tight as an M4, I guess, but it's definitely sport suspension. All right, can I go drive? Can I drive fast here anyway? Let's put it back to regular mode, and that basically turns the engine off. And it's hard to say whether the engine is on or off. You can hear it when it idles, but other than that, tell a lot from it. I was told that when the battery runs low, you run on the engine only, and you do feel the difference because obviously you just don't have all the torque. When we left, the charge indication was 10 miles, and we drove for a while and still shows 10. So I guess the battery holds charge pretty well if you do combined driving. Lot of looks with this car. You drive around, everybody stares. You can definitely feel it compared to driving a regular car. All right, let's see if we can accelerate a little bit more. Coming back, and I'm just trying to put my thoughts together. It's a very cool car. It's not a regular sports car. It's not a Porsche. I would say it's much more comfortable, because when you put on regular mode, it could be very quiet. It feels very smooth. you can have a lot of fun with this car. That's just what I feel about it. Not crazy fun. It's not an M4 fun. It doesn't have that horsepower, but it's a really cool car. That's about it. We're almost back. Thanks for watching.